Because we're going to hang out with you and welcome to Epcot. Thanks for joining us here today. If you are currently on the first floor and can't see me, that's because I'm directly above you on the second floor. And if you have any questions or I, you have them as soon as the presentation is over. All right now I'll start introducing you our two male managers. We'll start with this guy. Actually, we're both right here, but we'll start with the guy on the bottom. He's taking a little nap right now. He's very easy to identify. His name is Luke, and he's missing about 90% of his tail paddle. Now, the reason for that is because he was struck by a motorboat out in the wild, which unfortunately is not an uncommon occurrence, as about 85% of the manatees out there have been struck by motorboats and can be identified by the scars left by those accidents. Now, he is taking a nap right now, as I mentioned, however, if you get to see him when he's active, you'll be able to see that he does do very, very well. He swims with those front pectoral flippers a lot more than other manatees. And if you get the chance to compare the shoulder width, you'll be able to see that his shoulders are much, much larger. That's because he's all pure muscle up there. It has been about 7 years since the accident, so he's had that time to learn to cope with the loss of his tail paddle. Now our second manatee is over here on your, he's kind of making his way over here in the middle right now. Now he's going around, he's a little bit more energetic. He is our 7-year-old, he's a very young little boy. And he is, his name is Bach, and he was found as an orphan out by Jacksonville. Now unfortunately for him, manatees out in the wild, we usually stay with their mothers until they're about 5 years old. He was found at only about a week old. That's far too young to be on their own, as their mothers usually teach them everything they need to know, from what to eat and where to go to when they need to migrate. So he was brought into human care at a young age, which is another reason why you can see that he doesn't have any scars on him. Now, as you're watching, Bach is munching down this lettuce here. This is their main source of diet here at the Seas. They eat a lot of lettuce. However, out in the wild, obviously, they don't eat lettuce. They eat different types of sea grasses, algae, and lily pads, but they are strict herbivores, so they only eat vegetation. Out in the wild, they won't eat any meat and or fish. They are the only marine mammal to have a diet like that. So that's something that makes them a little bit special. Now, you're wondering, they're awfully big animals. Lou down there is 1,196 pounds, and our 7-year-old right here is 942 pounds. How do they get so big? As I said, they do get to be that big just on vegetation, and they don't have